and we will deliver this out to a selective detection of internal bypass patients. So I invite the speaker.
Ladies and ministers, good morning. I am Bruno Lawson. It is a great pleasure for me to present my research about the selective detection of ethanol bypass perforation. My research works are performed at Aix-Marseille University in IM2NP laboratory in France. This presentation will be focused on four main points. First, we'll make a brief history of the transdermal ethanol detection. Secondly, we will talk about the validation of transdermal ethanol detection using MOX commercial gas sensors. Next, we will talk about the development of our multi-sensors based on tin dioxide. And we will finish with the selective detection of transdermal ethanol in presence of acetone using a multi-sensor based on tin dioxide. My research works are part of APRISE Project, which means a personal health prevention assistant funded by Aix-Marseille University. The main objective of this project is the development of non-invasive microelectronic devices enabling the monitoring of vital human parameters such as electrocardiogram measurement or blood alcohol concentration. Our scientific approach to achieve this aim is the development of metal oxide gas sensors for continuous and non-invasive measurement of transdermal ethanol, able to correlate the transdermal ethanol with the blood alcohol concentration. In a way to have some idea of the phenomenon of perspiration, we will talk about the brief history of this phenomenon. So it was in 1614 that Santorio discovered that the phenomenon of perspiration is a vapor rose from the skin continuously, which is composed by more than 400 VOCs. Then Niemann and Paltrow demonstrate that 1% of total amount of ethanol consumed is eliminated through the skin. As you can see in this figure, we will exploit this concentration of ethanol. To have some idea of the ethanol concentration in human, when you consume 2 standard glasses of ethanol, it's equal to 140 ppm of ethanol in breath. So in the perspiration, you expected low concentration of ethanol. We can notice in the literature the development of SQRAM, which is able to monitor ethanol concentration through the perspiration using electrochemical sensors, which requires calorie calculation and currently used only for criminal reasons. So we need to validate the relevance of our detection method proposed. To demonstrate the relevance of this methodology, we carry out a clinical trials. During this clinical trials, which is being performed at Latimon Hospital in Marseille, in France, we detected 3 different analyses will be studied on subjects which have consumed alcohol during these clinical trials. First, we analyzed the blood alcohol concentration using gas chromatography coupled with flame ionization detection. Secondly, you detect breath alcohol using breathalyzer by Draeger. And third, you detected alcohol on the perspiration using MOX gas sensors. Here you can see some example of volunteers which has consumed ethanol. And here you're measuring the transdermal ethanol through the perspiration. Before carrying this clinical trial, we developed our test bench, which is composed by the automated evapor generation bench, the test chamber, and the control and data acquisition system. Here you can see the schematization of this measuring bench. We tested 6 different MOX commercial gas sensors under 1 ppm and 100 ppm with relative humidity of 50%. Here you can see that TGS, MIX, and CCS show the high response to ethanol compared to other gas sensors. So these 3 sensors have been selected according to 2 criteria, the sensitivity to ethanol and the power consumption, as you can see. If you are interested on the repeatability of these sensors, you can see that MIX, TG, and CCS demonstrate a lower repeatability, so they demonstrate acceptable responses on the ethanol. So these 3 kinds of sensors have been integrated in the wristband, as you can see here, and you develop the little cavity of perspiration collection. During this clinical trial, 6 different volunteers have been consumed ethanol, the beverage of vodka and orange juice, and we monitor his elimination of ethanol in three kinds of parameters. We chose 2 cohorts of bluff alcohol, 0.5 gram per liter and 0.8 gram per liter. And here in red, you can see the kinetic of elimination of ethanol in blood. In blue, you can see the elimination kinetics in breath. And in green, you can see the elimination ethanol through the perspiration monitoring by the MOX sensors. So, for the first time, you can easily say that you have a good correlation between the MOX sensors data and the data from blood and breath analysis. After demonstrating the relevance of this methodology, we developed our own MOX sensors. We use a transducer based on a multi-sensor system, as you can see here, patented by IM2NP Laboratory, composed by a substrate and silicon-silicon oxide with a membrane based on silicon nitrate. And you have digital electrode based on platinum, as you can see here, with an interval of 4 micrometers. This chip can integrate 3 different sensors, the S1, as you can see here, the S2, central sensors, and the S3. On this transistor, we deposit tin dioxide tin film by reactive magnetron RF sputtering. The tin dioxide has been elided at 500 degrees during 12 hours in a way to improve the stability, the crystallization, and the sensitivity to ethanol. We perform SEM and ESRD analysis, as you can see here, and on the SEM result, you can see that you have a good homogenization of the layer with average grain size between 20 and 25 nanometers, and some existence of porosity. On the ESRD analysis, you can see that you have a good crystallization of a sensitive layer with a peak corresponding to tetragonal structure phase of tin dioxide according to GCPDS card. Here we present the variation of the resistance of the central sensor S2 under 1 and 100 ppm of ethanol with relative humidity of 30%. As you can see here, you can observe that you have a good variation or high variation of the resistance with a response time for 50 ppm of 9 seconds and recovery time of 7 minutes. If you are interested in the humidity effect, you've done this study, so you can see that when the relative humidity increases, the sensor responses decrease. But you can, however, at relative humidity of 75%, you can observe that you can detect different concentrations of ethanol. Now, I show the response of the multi-sensors. In blue, you can see the response of S1. In red, you can see the response of S2 and the S3 in green. Here, you can see that the high variation of resistance occurs on the sensor S2, the middle sensor, and you can see that in the sensitive layers, you can see that the S2 demonstrates a high sensitivity to ethanol compared to S1 and S3, and the 3 kinds of sensors follow a power loop function. Now we will focus on the selectivity study. The main interferon gases emitted by the skin are acetone, acetone, and humidity. Our scientific approach for the selective study consists to exploit the temperature between S2 sensors and S1 and S3 sensors. We will perform several measurements as defined below, as you can see ethanol, acetone, and different mixture of acetone and with ethanol, with different concentrations, as you can see in the tableau. And each measurement has been repeated 5 times. We use, after that, the well-known technique of pattern recognition technique, which is a principal component analysis. Here, I show the 2 kinds of examples of when the multi-sensors operating on the ethanol, 50 ppm of ethanol with relative humidity of 50%. Here we have 50 ppm of ethanol add to 2 ppm of acetone. You can see that you have different variation on the resistance of the different sensors and many difference of the slope of the curve. So all of these parameters can be used for the PCA analysis. But in the following, the PCA response I will show you in the following, which based only on the response sensor responses. First, you can observe that the principal component show that S2 sensors response are in distant zone from the sensors S1 and S3 due to the temperature differences about in here about 20 degrees. The main result of this principal component analysis, here you can see in blue you have the mixture of acetone and ethanol and humidity. Here you have in purple you have the acetone different concentration. In green you have the ethanol, only ethanol, and here you have the mixture of acetone and ethanol without humidity. So first you can see that at low concentration of ethanol, 10 ppm, you are able to dissociate acetone and ethanol. And the second conclusion is PCR allows us to dissociate ethanol in binary mixture of ethanol or ethanol acetone and from acetone, ethanol, and humidity. So, in conclusion, our previous work demonstrated for the first time that blood alcohol concentration can be monitoring indirectly in non-invasive way and continuously using MOX sensors. And we have developed a multi-sensor based on tin dioxide, which is demonstrated a good sensitivity, a good repeatability, and low power consumption. And we carry out various different measurements, and the use of PCR allows us to discriminate ethanol from acetone and humidity. So at look, we can increase the selectivity of the ethanol detection, for example, by decorating tin dioxide with different nanoparticles, such as palladium or gold, and you can use the signal processing to improve this selectivity. So thank you for your kind attention. I have some pictures.
Thank you.